Hi, I'm Amy Kelly for Tooele TV, and today, this is a story that's very dear to my heart. Now, some of you may know that my little boy passed away almost a year ago, coming up in the end of October. He had autism and seizures, and I was so blessed at one of our past shows to meet this woman. It's Christine Johnson, and she has a darling little boy named Dylan who has autism and seizures, and you know, I've been trying to raise money for seizure dogs, and they are in the process of getting a seizure dog, a service dog for their son. Christine, tell me about the process and what brought you to this point to be able to find a dog for your son.
Dylan is a runner, and he is very hyperactive, so we wanted something that would help calm him and be a support to him and also help keep him safe. And I saw an article actually in the Deseret News about a service dog for a boy with autism. And I'm like, I gotta research this. This would be perfect for Dylan. He loves animals and this would help him so much. So I started researching.
And how long ago was that process begun then?
That was last spring. I started researching on service dogs, and there's lots of foundations across America that have service dogs for children with autism. And I found Autism Service Dogs of America.
Now, what made you select them out of everybody that's out there? And there are lots. How did you come across this?
They are in Oregon, and I loved them because they only specialize in autism dogs. They only train autism dogs, and they have been doing it for 15 years. Mm. So they really know what they're doing. And the lady that founded it was a special education teacher.
Wow, so even more understanding, it sounds like.
Mm-hmm. And they actually train the dog, and you go up and visit, stay with them for a week, and then they fly out and spend a week in your community and school, showing the school how to use the dog. So they're really on the ball. You don't just go pick up your dog and go home. It's very intense.
So they're getting everybody else acclimated to the idea of working with that dog as well.
The dog, I know, is being trained to deal with his autism, with his tantrums, but these dogs are very sensitive, and I have great faith that it will be able to know what's going on with Dylan. If it's a change in his mood, that it will know what's going on and be able to warn us of anything that's going to be going on with him.
Now, when you bring this dog home, what are some changes that will be made in your schedule? I mean, with this dog in your home, I'm just curious how that will fit in.
Well, we have to be accountable, you know, for this dog's whole day. You know, it's working. So it works 10 hours a day, which means, but it also has to have downtime. It has to have play time. It has to have rest time. And so we have to change our schedule as a family and have it coordinate with the dog's schedule as far as sleeping and when it's eating and when it's working and when it's not working. It needs to be able to be off.
Right.
And not be like at attention.
Oh my gosh. So they do get a break, because I wondered how that worked.
Yeah.
Now, is this dog going to be specifically just for Dylan? The family is not really allowed to interact with it, or how does that work?
The dog is for Dylan. It will respond to me. I'm its mom, okay, per se, and I will be, you know, directing it, but it is Dylan's dog, and we will, you know, as a family, all enjoy its company, but when it's working, we don't call it its name other than myself or Dylan, address it, because we don't want to distract. So it's not everybody will know its name when we go out in public. We don't want people to know its name so it can focus and work.
Oh my goodness, that is so neat. And so he'll actually be going to school with Dylan.
Yeah, the dog will go with Dylan. We don't know who his dog is yet. It's still in training, but it will go to school with him. They have trained these dogs to hold their bladder.
Oh my goodness.
For 8 hours.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, that's part of their training, and they teach the teacher, you know, what they need to do to have this dog work in the classroom with Dylan. And they are protected by the American Disabilities Act. So they have every right to be at the school with the child. There's not one place this dog cannot go.
Oh my
gosh. Everywhere.
This just warms my heart, the excitement. Tell me how much these dogs cost.
Well, this foundation charges $13,500 for the dog, and that is just a part of the actual cost. It costs them probably $20,000 or more to train these dogs. They have puppy trainers working with them. They are very elite dogs. They're like from top breeders. They want good temperament, good pedigree, and they're with someone 24 hours a day, 7 days a week while they're training, and it can take 18 to 24 months for the dog to be ready to be with a child. So it's a lot. And food and vet care, all those things.
Now, we're close to your goal. Can you tell everybody how close we are?
We are very close. The goal is $13,500, and we're just about at $10,000. And we're just very grateful for wonderful people donating. Businesses have been very generous, and we were able to do bake sales. And I was amazed at how kind and gracious people were at buying stuff and supporting our cause.
The dog is almost ready by next spring, you say?
Yeah, it should be ready. I'm hoping for Christmas that we will know which dog is his. That's all I want, is the dog's name and a picture. And then we should know, like, by March. And be able to go get the dog in the spring, if not sooner. But we are getting really close, so I keep teasing that we're going to have an 80-pound baby in 8 months.
Yes, you will. Yes, you definitely will. And we're going to help you get there. And like I said, look below this video. There'll be information and contact information on how you can get a hold of Christine or further help with the donation process. This is for a wonderful cause. These children need the help. And these dogs become an integral part of our society and are actually going to be a blessing to all the children in Dylan's class.
Yeah, Dylan is going to be in a severe classroom with other children who have autism. Some are nonverbal. And all these children will benefit from this dog, because if someone is upset or sad or having a tantrum, this dog is trained to actually do deep pressure massages just to sit and, you know, give comfort to a child in need. And that will bless Dylan and other children in the classroom. So I am grateful for this opportunity.
Well, Christine, I love you. I do. I love you, and I'm so happy for you, and I want to do all I can help, and you can do the same. So please support those local people in your community who are in need. This is wonderful. This is going to be a blessing, and we can make it a possibility for her family to have a better life, and all of us, really. So, like I said, look below the video. You'll know what to do, and keep watching Tooele TV. As usual, we'll be bringing you lots of human interest stories and different things around our community. We appreciate you watching. Thanks again. I'm Amy Kelly.